Teacher Svetlana is here, and today we will be talking about Indian shadow puppets. Shadow puppets are an ancient part of Indian culture. Artists perform plays using colorful puppets made out of translucent leather with cutouts. Puppets are controlled using attached sticks that can be held by one artist or many. Ramayana is India's best-loved story that is often performed in public. It tells a story of a handsome Prince Rama whose wife Sita was stolen by the demon Ravana. Rama saved Sita with the help of his brother Lakshman and loyal monkey god Hanuman in a series of heroic battles.
My name is Daphne, and we'll be showing a story about Rama and Sita and a monster monkey. And a monster who tries to take Sita, and then Rama calls
the god monkey,
and then the god monkey saves Sita, and then they live happily ever after. What a wonderful day, isn't it?
Yeah.
What shall we do tonight? Should we go to the forest? Okay, la la la. Hey, Sita! Now you're gonna be my dinner. God, monkey, come! Oh, there you are! Thank you. I'm so glad you're here. Can you swing on those trees? I know you can be.
A puppet of a monkey god. He can turn into a regular monkey or a giant, so I'm making him a human body with the monkey head. First, position the character on a paper by slightly sketching the whole body, and then start figuring out details. Remember, the character needs to be recognizable as a silhouette, so it's best to do the head in a profile. I skipped the part where I draw details, so you see my final sketch. If you will be using white cardstock paper for final puppet, you can transfer your sketch to it by putting graphite on the back of the sketch and tracing it over. I will use craft paper for puppet, which is brown, so I will be cutting out the sketch and then outlining the shape. Now the tricky part. You need to decide which part of the puppet will be moving. Please remember that human body moves in the joints. You can move head, torso in the waist area, legs in the hips area and knees, arms pivot around the shoulder joint, and you can fold arms in the elbow, and you also can move feet and hands. In order to connect the arms to body, I need the connecting parts to have an extra space where they intersect. So I add extra around the shoulders, on the body and arms. You don't want to have too many moving parts on your puppet, since you will need to control them individually. You have only two hands to do it, so 2-3 parts are enough. I added details to my puppet and colored it. After cutting parts out, it's time to assemble the puppet. For assembly, you probably will need the help of an adult. We need to punch a hole in connecting parts. Hole puncher like this can be used or just a needle. You will also need a paper fasteners like this. They can be different shape and sizes. If you don't have a paper fastener, you can use the wire, a very thin wire, to attach two pieces. Just cut a little piece of the wire and then use your fingers to make some sort of the knot or a swirl in the end of the wire. Punch it through the both of the pieces and then swirl it on the other end to attach the piece. You can decorate the puppet even more by making holes along the design. The light will go through them, adding more details to your puppet for your performance. Now you need to attach sticks to control the parts of the puppet. You can use straws for that, or craft sticks, or even pencils, and a clear tape. Attach a straw to each part that you will be moving. I'm attaching to both arms, and also to a body, so I can fully control it. Now for a fun part. To make a show, you will need a shadow theater box. I made my own by cutting out the side of the box and taping a tracing paper over the opening. The opposite side of the box needs to be cut out as well, so you can place your puppet against the screen. Don't forget to put a lamp in the back. Now it is your turn to make your own shadow puppet, create your own story, or use Ramayana characters. Good luck!